version of the Dr. Oz Show.
This audio is used for the transcriber test at Gotranscript.
It is 8 o'clock in the evening and I am watching TV and the Lithuanian version of the Dr. Oz Show. Today, some guys share their stories of losing 120 pounds. You would ask me, Laura, how much is that in kilos? Well, Google states that it equals to almost 55 kilograms. Can you imagine what you would look like if you lost 55 kilos? That is insane.
This audio is used for the transcriber test at Gotranscript.
You would be like, wow, how is that possible? Especially in such a short time. I mean, he lost this weight in 6 months. What is talking about is having smaller meal portions and practicing IF. When I heard about it for the first time, I was like, what is IF? It is interesting to listen to weight loss stories that are related to IF.
This audio is used for the transcriber test at Gotranscript.
Well, IF stands for intermittent fasting. Intermittent fasting is a term of meal planning during a specific period of the day. It is not about what you eat. It is more about when you eat. This trend has been getting lots of buzz lately, and that is why I would like to talk about it as well. Intermittent fasting can be done in so many different ways. However, the most popular method is probably the 16-to-8 ratio, which means that in any 24 hours, you would have to consume all your food intake in 8 hours. For instance, the eating window could be from 6 a.m. to 2 p.m., 9 a.m. to 5 p.m., or 12 p.m. to 8 p.m. There are also many other alternatives, such as the 18-to-6 ratio, the 20-to-4 ratio, the 23-to-1 ratio, which can be known as OMAD, or even prolonged fasting, which lasts 4 to 7 days usually. When I told some of my friends that I was going to start IF, some of them were like, Laura, are you nuts? It may sound like a bad idea from the first sight, but now I feel great. Therefore, for now, I would like to talk about the prolonged fasting, also known as PF. There are many articles published about the prolonged fasting and its positive impact on the body. For instance, in 2010, Isabel Rubio Aliaga and her colleagues from Robert Gordon University published an article, Metabolomics of Prolonged Fasting in Humans, reveals new catabolic markers, and it is about the human response to prolonged fasting.
This audio is used for the transcriber test at Gotranscript.
There are many benefits of prolonged fasting, such as better blood pressure, mental clarity, as well as extra energy, weight loss, and longevity. There is a term, autophagy. Even nowadays, many people are like, huh? What is autophagy? Well, many scientists claim that there is no need to have extreme juice diets to detoxify your body if you do prolonged fasting once in a while. Prolonged fasting promotes autophagy, which is a natural way for the body to get rid of damaged cells and produce new ones. But this process usually begins when you spend an extended time without any food intake. You know, I am not a scientist, to be honest. I cannot explain all the benefits in such a scientific way, but it is said autophagy promotes longevity and youthful looks. Also, there are many weight loss stories on how IF helps lose weight. Recently, I have come across a YouTube channel called Fledge Fitness, which strongly promotes intermittent fasting if people want to lose weight without reducing the muscle mass. By the looks of Edward Vasquez, who is also the owner of Fledge Fitness LLC, I tend to believe him because, I mean, just look at him. He is well-built, even though he clearly states to be fasting for extended periods regularly.
This audio is used for the transcriber test at Gotranscript.